Let's just see what kind of firewood we got going here next. And Art and Luthier. Sorry for the shitty camera work, folks. But anyway, I'll show you what I see right away. Well, it's a bolt-on neck, but I don't know if the camera can catch it. There's only one bolt. So I'm going to just tune it up. Let's see what goes on, but we got to find another bolt for that. Okay, it's tuned up. I could be like 0 for 2 today. Nothing's going to work right today. So everything's going to be junk today. So we have a neck relief that is close but no cigars. So that's a good start. Provided the truss rod thing works, we're good. But the string height, even with the neck relief will help this a little bit, but not really. We have a whopping 8 64s. Most I'd like to see is about 6, between 5 and 6. So that means, take out 3 64s times 2 is 6 64s. All right, do your math, folks, do your math. So provided other things work, we're gonna take 3/32 of an inch off the bottom of that bridge saddle. Okay, let's see if the truss rod actually works. This could all be going in the fireplace in a moment. When you see that the tiny little screw that holds the truss rod cover on is stripped, I'm expecting trouble. See what happens. I really want to try loosening it first, David. Well, she's creaky, but she turns. Attempt to give it a quarter turn. The relief is very close, but obviously the string action is whacked. Tiny more, another 1/8 of a turn possibly should get this, but I mean the strings are coming off anyway. I just want to make sure it works and does its job. I'm going to remeasure the string height again once I get the relief correct. It does affect it a little bit, not a lot. Well, we're not quite there yet, boys and girls. Stand by. 4 attempts later, I think we sort of got it. What's Mr. String Height doing? Yeah, it's a tiny bit better. So we're sitting at 7 64s now, so I want to bring it down. We're going to call it, man, that's shaving it. 6, 1. I'm going to take it down 2 64s, which is 132 off the bridge setup. Let's open it up and see what the hell's going on with that bolt that's missing. So I'm removing the one existing bolt. I think I've been down this road before. I'm not gonna get that. And I might even have one from last time. Did we win? Sure we did. Come to me. That looks like 1/4 20 by 1.5 inches to me. Let's see if I have one. Remember, I said I've been down this road before? 1/4 20, 1.5 inches. Now all I have to do is find a washer. That'll be probably a bigger quest than finding that stupid bolt. Oh, look! The fricker jumped right out at me. Could this be the one? Could it be true? It might be a little big. I have to go to the washer department. I'll be back. I was totally incorrect in that assumption. That washer will be fine. It'll be tough though. I can see why somebody probably gave up. They probably couldn't get their hand in here, or they didn't have the right wrench to tighten it up. And it remains to be seen if I have the right wrench to tighten this up too.
The hard part is finding it. There it is.
All right, that's been solved. We have two bolts to bolt the neck onto the guitar, I think. Is this turning? Yeah, that's tightening. There we go. All right. I'll be back in a minute after I put away some junk. Don't you just love arts and crafts? I don't like that one. It only does 16ths. What did I say I wanted to take off of here? A 32 of an inch. Here it is. Actually, we're going to do it like this. Only because... why screw up, right? Uno. Duzo. Join those marks. Very, very carefully join those marks. This is a great little pen I got, and I was using, it was a 0.5 millimeter lead pencil, but this is a pigment liner made in Germany. It's basically for drafting, but it does 0.1. And it is an ink, not a lead. So that was sort of a find. I was looking in the wrong department. Right? I needed to look into the drafting department to find that.
So I'm going to rev up the little belt sander rig, and I got my vacky sucker sucking the dust best it can. And I'm going to remember to clean up and dress my Freddy racers today. Let's do this. And I finally remembered to dress all the goo off my Freddy racers when I had the sander out. Look, I'm getting smarter. My memory's coming back. Look out.
Today's string choice will be these.
Okay, so we have strings. And I want to revisit this truss rod adjustment just because now we have two bolts in the neck as opposed to one. How does that happen? Like, I know I've had one like this before too. Like, did someone take it out? Did someone thought it worked better without it? Right now, I would not touch that at all. So we'll just stop there. How did our string height turn out after I shaved it? How'd that work out? We have just above 5/64 between 5 and 6, and right just above between 4 and 5 on the E, and I'm measuring that as a 12th fret in case anybody's wondering, but it, instead of going in the campfire, it can now play by the campfire. Kind of a quiet thing, but it is what it is. Anyway, thanks for hanging out, folks. Another guitar that will play better than it did when it showed up. That's about all we can do. Thanks for hanging out. All the links to stuff are below. Special shout out to all my patrons, subscribers, Facebook followers. Get a sticker. Most of all, be good to each other. Cheers.